And welcome to this tutorial. Today I will show you how to mess around with the DNS settings and how you can actually redirect the traffic of a particular user to somewhere, I don't know, to wherever you want, to your malicious site where you can deploy exploits and so on and so forth. Anyway, what I mean by this is that somebody will enter a domain name into a browser. Let me just show you. So open up a browser like this, and I don't know, it's a bit slow today, probably because I have 10 billion things running. Anyway, you would type in, I don't know, let's say www.facebook.com, because we're going to use this as our experimental site for today's work, primarily because it has really good security, but we're not going to do anything to facebook.com anyway, to the official domain. What person will enter a domain name like this, and instead of being redirected to the proper IP address, they will be redirected to some IP address that we type in, so our IP address, where there will be a web server listening to receive that traffic, and once that traffic is received, they will get an exact clone of the website where they will be entering their credentials. Once they actually have entered them, we will have them and we will be able to do with them as we choose and please. Now, this is just an example of how things can run, not necessarily that they will run in all cases, and specific cases may require adjustments, so to say, depending on what sort of a site is it, how to approach it, and so on and so forth. Anyway, so for the purposes of this tutorial, I have two virtual machines. One is Kali Linux, and the other one shall be my Windows 8.1 machine. That will be a victim. Don't have any real machines here to test it out on, like test it out on 3 or 4 different real machines, but it does not matter. It really doesn't matter. The procedure is exactly the same. There are literally no differences, and the best part is that you can actually combine this technique with some of the things that we have learned in the previous tutorials. For example, this technique can be also combined with SSL strip, although that's a bit more complex method, or that requires a bit more complexity to it. Anyway, let me just boot this machine up. And while that is booting, let us go over to our Kali Linux box. I'm going to go ahead and log in here. And it looks like the guest edition's broke. Oh no, I have a full screen. It just takes a bit to load because I am running several virtual machines at once. Now, there are several tools which we will need. Fortunately for us, we don't actually need to install anything. All these things come pre-installed with Kali Linux. If you want to use a different Linux distro, you can install these things. It's nothing too difficult or anything of a kind. They're pretty easy to install. You can find them on the net and the official sites and download and install them from there. I am disconnected. Why am I disconnected? Let's have a look. Network settings. Of course, because I'm going over wireless and I'm now connected to the wired network. Anyway, make sure that your virtual machine is actually connected to the net and that you have access to it. I will have it in a moment, and there we go. Let me just confirm that I have access to the net, but even if I don't, I should be able to do this. However, you won't be able to do this externally if you don't have access to the internet. Let's just try it. Ping google.com. Excellent, so I am getting a reply. I am connected. Anyway, now that we have our Kali Linux running, and in the previous tutorials, we have actually managed to compromise a router. So by utilizing that router, we're going to effectively change its DNS settings. We will tell it that the DNS is actually our virtual machine. And as soon as this browser opens, I'll show you what I mean by it. Oops, there we go. Come on. Oops, there. 192. .168.1.1. We have already gotten the user credentials in the previous tutorials. Here we're just going to apply them. And there we go. Let me just zoom it in for you. So this is the interface of a TP-Link router, and there are lots of settings here, but we are interested in the DNS settings, and let me just find them to see where they are. You will encounter a lot of things in these routers. You will encounter different configurations, different setups, and it's sometimes it can get a bit tiring to actually find where is what. Now, on advanced setup, you have firewall. Now, if you already breached a router, you can actually disable a firewall, which is fantastic. So even the ping of death will fly if the firewall isn't up and running. I suspect that is true, as the firewall is the only thing blocking it here, as far as I can see. Now you have a lot of other things. You have NAT. You have routing to see who is connected. Other things as well. You have VLAN. You can go into ADSL and actually figure out the credentials there as well. But we are not interested in any of those things. We are at the moment looking for the DNS settings, and I suspect I might find it here under Internet. To get IP address, static IP gateway, NAT, default route, TCP, encapsulation, service bridge, ISP, virtual circuit. Okay, apparently it is not here. Let's go to the next one. It says, there we go. So it says user use auto discover DNS server only, and I don't want that to happen. I want to use user discover DNS servers only to give me an option for myself to type in whatever I want. And I'm going to type in the IP address of my virtual machine. You can get it by typing in ifconfig. Oops. Excellent, there we go. So this is the IP address. Now these IP addresses are dynamic, and hopefully they won't change for the duration of this tutorial. In order to perform this attack on a larger scale, like if you want to remotely do this, because this attack is actually meant to be done on remote basis. So let's say that you're somewhere in Europe and somebody else is like in Eastern Russia or something like that. You would be able to do this, but you would need to have a static public IP address, not necessarily even static, but you would need to do significant configuration to your router in order to be able to do this. However, I recommend, for the ease of use, just to get a VPN, and I have described how to use VPNs in the previous tutorial, so you can go back there and figure out how to use a VPN. And once you have a VPN static IP address, then you can actually perform this attack on great distances outside of local networks. I will type in this server here, and once you actually type in your fake DNS server that you will create, the IP address of that server, it is always a good idea to have a fallback here. So the fallback here will be 8.8.8.8.8. This is the public Google DNS. These are public Google DNS servers. You can all feel free to use them. That's why they're there. They're pretty good, actually. OpenDNS and Google DNS servers. Those are the two best DNS servers out there in the world, as far as I know. And people tend to use them as they are quite secure. Reason why I'm putting the second method here is that you are not going to have this server of yours running non-stop. You want to run it for a certain period of time, get what you need, and then you might want to turn your machine off or something like that. And once you do that, your victim will be unable to browse the web, and you will raise suspicion, you will raise a lot of red flags, and that can be extremely problematic. So that's definitely something you want to have here so that it will keep on functioning even if your fake DNS server is not functioning. Click save and wait for it. It's gonna save eventually. These routers are not state-of-the-art, and they tend to be kind of slow, so keep that in mind. Don't immediately be frustrated if it doesn't work out the first time. Just try it a couple of times and it should work just fine. Let me just go ahead and clear this screen. Now, in the next tutorial, in the follow-up tutorial, we will actually employ some tools and see what we can do with them. Until then, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you in the next follow-up tutorial.